SLK swap, plan F. I don't even remember how many plans we have changed with this engine. Anyhow, yesterday I put the hook here up. That's why you have these two bolts. This, otherwise from where you're gonna grab it. You have one attachment point here, another one here, back. And somebody mentioned also about the bracket that he's not gonna rely on these bolts. Have you seen the original one here? Have you ever seen the original, or have you seen another car that say how it is the hook? I'm gonna show you for the M57, the original one, how this looks like. And then he mentioned that I'm not gonna trust this bracket. Don't. I will. Anyhow, now AC compressor plug back in place, beautiful. Soldering iron here, the soldering material. Couple of wirings from here, like I said, the starter and for the oil level sensor. It goes back in place. We changed the plans on that. The customer is supposed to bring me the headers, but they told me that there was some problems and they're not gonna bring the headers, so we're gonna put the stock headers on. That's one thing. Then somebody mentioned if I'm pulling the engines from up, I think something like that, maybe. I'm never pulling an engine from up since the engine has a cross member, because this is how they install it from the factory, and this is the most cleanest way to install it back. That means subframe or cross member, call it as you like, with the engine, with the transmission, all together down on a table. Yeah, it's not a good example to show you example from the Porsche, right? A Porsche, you can lift it up even if you want. But if you see the previous videos on the SLK, you can see nice, the heat seals, no single scratch, no problem, no nothing, all right? Beautiful. You're making down, you make some, we are putting some nylon here, let us say there, wood in the middle, so don't hurt anything. Stepping on the rubber, you align everything, you align the subframe and the transmission, and then it goes at, direct on the at the points. You're not misaligning or something. That's the best way for me, and I will not gonna change it. Even if you have to spend, let us say, one more hour, one extra hour, but like this, you're not scratching anything, you're not damaging anything, and you're secure, you're safe, everything beautiful. You don't have to remove the lower arms. Just turn it like this, and you're gonna be fine. Stabilize the bar link, let us say, over there. This is for the steering rack, the plug. You see how nice it is without a single scratch? That means we're gonna put by again, nobody's gonna understand that somebody removed the engine or removed the cross member or whatever. That's the thing. So again, even if it was my car, I'm not gonna pull the engine from up. I'm gonna pull the engine from up only if you cannot remove the subframe. If it's a solid, if it's an old car, let us say, and you cannot take it out the subframe, then yes, you don't have a chance, right? You have to lift it up from up. You have to take it from up. But in this case, no, obviously. Altogether down, and if you want my opinion, it's faster and much more easy to drop it down than to lift, to pull it from up. Me, my opinion. Maybe I'm wrong, but it is what it is. Anyhow, putting back the stock headers with the new gaskets, put the transmission, actually need the flex plate bolts, the new one, because these are the old one. The damper pulley already torque it, that's why I put these bolts back to torque the damper pulley bolt. It's been torqued down. These are the old one. I'm expecting to get the new one, to remove this and put the new one. The transmission is ready. I already changed the clutches. The clutches already installed. This is the torque converter that I'm gonna use. So, yeah, pretty much that's it. We're gonna see this later. Later, when they bring me the bolts, I'm gonna put the bolts, I'm gonna put the transmission. I need also help from the other guys, because I have now an engine set, we're gonna continue the engine, and later on, when they come, the rest of the people, because early, I'm gonna continue on that. So I have to spin a little bit the engine to align the bolts here, to come down here, where's the window, because you have to bolt it from back. Yep, pretty much that's it up to now. Later on, we're gonna continue. By the way, because I'll forget it, all right? This is the bracket, original bracket, all right? For M157 M278, okay? This is what goes front. This is tend also to bend. All right. So 5.5 liters engine, twin turbo application. This is what I fix for the supercharger, for the Mon 3K. This is for the Mon 5.7. So, I mean, you see the difference, right? I don't know if you understand. To say that you're not gonna rely on these bolts to lift up the engine, first of all, you're not lifting up from one point, you're lifting from the 3 points, like always. And then you have this for the Mon 5.7 that I have used how many times? All right, actually, I have another one. I always have three, but I see the other one. So this is rated for 170 kilograms. Think about this one for how much rated. And again, if you don't know, don't talk. You just, yeah, okay, it is what it is. Anyhow, if you don't like it, do whatever you want, do whatever you like. All right, headers on, engine on the correct position where it's supposed to be, under the car. All right, the wiring for the oil level sensor. 1 second, where's the light? In place. This for the alternator, have to add another one pin here. For the starter, the heat seat that has a starter here, back in place. Headers on this side. Transmission back in place. Nice, we have some progress at least. And I was willing also to put the cover here, the plastic one, eh? And I was thinking that we can close the bonnet, right? Yeah. Tell me about it. See where is the rubber back over there. And see from this side. Oh boy. Here, this rubber steps here. Right? Let's find out. There is only one way to find out. Okay, there is a safe here. No, there's no safe. There's no safe there, so we can close it. Yeah, we can. Oh boy. Alright. I was not expecting that. Not bad. Not bad. Alright. I was not expecting that, honestly. Not bad. Not bad. Mr. Nofu, can you pop up the hood? Not bad at all. Alright. Did it touch anywhere? That looks like that. Leave any mark or something. What are we gonna do here? Play doll. Play doll on the higher spot here with a nylon to don't stick the play doll on the bonnet up to see how much clearance we have. Same thing what we are doing for the valve clearance on the piston, but in this case we have to see the supercharger with the bonnet clearance. Alright, that's not bad, that's not bad at all. This is looking good. Obviously we need one modification here. We're gonna put an adapter here. Yeah. We're gonna use this hose and one adapter here. Looks nice. Not bad, not bad. We are looking good. I wish that we're gonna be able to put the cover, but I doubt we're gonna come the cover. I believe that the cover is gonna hit over there. Probably. I'll know if I put it on, right? Yeah. This line, the ground. Nice, nice. I like it. I love it. Not bad at all. It was a headache, you know. So there we have the oil cooler with integrated fan. I don't remember if I saw you earlier for the E55. And these are the oil cooler lines from the 55. Some small modifications. It's not touching anywhere.
No.
I'm gonna put, you know what I'm gonna do? I'm gonna put a plate all here and there, where's the higher spot.
Okay, okay.
With a nylon on top, don't stick anywhere. You know, closing the bond to see how much clearance we have.
Yeah.
Also here, let us say, just in case, to be safe, to don't make, let us say, the engine like this. And now it's a good chance because the engine mounts are brand new, they're clean, they're very, very good, you know. So it's not like that we have an old engine mounts. Nice, good, okay. That's it for now. Next, we have to take care about the oil cooler, fix the oil cooler, fix the intercooler front, intercooler pump. What else? Ah, the mid pipes for the exhaust. Then the fuel system, we have also the wiring there, the ECU from the 55, stuff like that. All right, that's it for now. Thank you.